just don't know how to let it all pour out. And though I'm silent, my heart is crying, 'cause I was made to come to you. So I pray, God, I need you more than words can say. Right here in this moment, you know my heart, you know my need, you know every part of me. So even if it's just to speak your name, I'm gonna. Desperate place, Father, I know you can bear the weight, Father, take me in your arms as I speak your name. I lift my hands and pray.
Sacrifice, for I am sets me free. I will glory in the power of the cross. The things I thought were gain, I count as loss.
Good morning, Jerry Vail. So exciting to be here this morning. Don't you just love this weather? Yes, I just love it. Just cool, and I'm just feel so good. I said I wasn't going to complain, but I'm complaining. Oh, well. Got hot there the few days, didn't it? So we're excited to be here to worship with you this morning. We're still working on and praying about how to reopen safely for folks. Continue, if you will, to visit people, take your lawn chair, and just go visit with them. Doesn't have to be very long, just go and visit with people. They're so excited. If you would like to do a little note, a little letter, or a little note that we put in the packets to send out to folks each month, we really appreciate that. Allison did one this time, and so we'll put that in the packet to send out to those folks, those members and friends that don't have technology. So I ask you to do a little note or something that we can send in. Sherry's been doing some, Wade did some. So if you could do that, that would be greatly appreciated, and I know the folks that don't have technology will be great glad to hear. So a little something on what you've been doing during this quarantine and how things are going. So if you would do that, we would greatly appreciate it a bunch. Okay, so if you would join me for the prayer of confession, if you would. It is with a sense of shame that we confess how often we have turned a deaf ear to your call. To your call, O God, you have opened before us waves of opportunities, but our lives have pressed us in other directions. Too much our values and priorities have been confused. Too regularly our vision has been clouded. We have made poor use of our time and our talents. Forgive us, God. Forgive us and call on us again. Awaken in us a renewed passion and devotion, and supply the vision of the coming reign that is already breaking into our existence and making all things new. Amen. Amen. All right, children, come on around, because Lisa and Grace are going to give us a children's time. So come on around and let's hear from Lisa and Grace.
Good morning, boys and girls. I want to talk to you this morning about God's grace for each one of us. But first, I want you to meet someone. This is my FBFF, my furry best friend forever. And oddly enough, her name is Grace. A long time ago, all the way back in 2011, before a lot of you were even born, I didn't have a dog. I wasn't looking for a dog or thinking about a dog. I didn't even really want a dog because they're a lot of responsibility. But one day, this little FBFF showed up in my family's life needing a family of her own. We weren't looking for her. We didn't know we wanted her. But God sent her to us, and we quickly realized that he sent us something special that we didn't even know we were missing. Grace has been a best friend and a constant companion since the day she found us. And really, I don't think any of us can remember a time that we didn't have Grace. She has brought us so much joy and happiness. So, real quick, she has a trick or two that she's pretty good at when she's in the mood for it. Let's see if we can get her to do it. You guys watch, okay? All right, you ready, Gracie? Down. Good girl. Roll over. Roll over. Oh, good girl. Good girl, Gracie. Good girl. Here's some treats for you. Now I want to tell you about God's grace for each of you. In our Bibles, there's a letter that the Apostle Paul wrote to the people living in Rome, which is the book we call the Book of Romans in the Bible. And in chapter 3, verses 23 and 24, it says, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, but they are justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus." Now, what all that means is that when we make mistakes, God forgives us. No fuss, no muss, he just does it. But what is sin? Sin is making mistakes. It's forgetting to follow God's ways and doing things our own way. Who has sinned? Well, the answer to that is really easy. All of us have sinned. I have sinned. You guys have sinned. Your parents sin. Your teachers sin. Your friends sin. Pastor Viv sins. We all sin. But here is the good news that Paul knew. Even when we make mistakes, even when we sin, God still loves us and forgives us. We don't have to do anything but ask, and he forgives us because he loves us so much. Jesus was sent here by God to help us understand that. It's called God's grace, and you cannot earn it. You cannot buy it. It's God's freely given gift to us just because he loves us. You cannot do good deeds to get it. You can't give lots of money to the church to get it. You only get it because God wants to give it. That is a gift worth celebrating, and it's news worth sharing. So, like we talked about last week, y'all go and tell everyone about God's love and about God's gift of grace for every one of us. Amen? Let's have a prayer together. So get in close and hold hands with whoever's around you. You ready? Dear God, we can never thank you enough for your grace. We don't deserve it, but you give it to us anyway, freely. Please help us show that same grace to the people around us who make mistakes. Show us the path to loving everyone the way you love and the way Jesus loves us. We love you, Lord, and we thank you. Amen. All right, kiddos, go forth and tell all the good news that you know about God. And when you see a cute little dog somewhere, you think about my cute little Gracie, and you remember God's grace for all of us. Love you guys. See you soon.
All right. Thank you, Lisa and Grace. That was exciting. Yes, what a great name for a dog, Grace. Yes. And now we come to pastoral prayer, prayer for those in our hearts, for everything that's going on. So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father God, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We thank you, Lord, for your grace. For your grace. Oh, we so dearly need grace. Father God, we lift up our country. We lift up our country and we ask that your hand, your angels start to sweep, Lord, over this country. From one town to the next. From one person, Father God, touch their hearts. Help us, Father, to turn to you for your wisdom and your discernment. Help us to turn to you. Father God, we lift up our military men and women and their families all around the world, for so few take care of so many. Father, we lift up all our first responders, fire, rescue, police. Lord, just put your hedge of protection around them. Father, it is a tense time. And we're all human. And we all make mistakes. We all fall short of the glory of God. Father, just give wisdom. Father, we lift up the protesters, Father God, those that are wanting to protest peacefully, Father. We just ask protection around them. And Father, those that want to do destruction and, Lord, to tear down rather than to make new, we just ask now that your angels will convict and touch them. There is always a better way. May we make a commitment not to go back, but to go forward. But this destruction does not help. Oh, Father, give our leaders wisdom. Especially leaders all over the world, but especially the leaders of this country, Father. That they may have wisdom to build up, not to tear down, to mend, not to separate us. Father God, please give them courage to seek you, Father. Oh, Father, we lift up those on our hearts that need healing, that need deliverance from addiction, loneliness, those that grieve many things, loss of a loved one, loss of health, loss of mobility, Father God, loss of provision in this time of economic downturn. Father God, we just ask that your presence, your power be just flow over this country and the world. Father, we ask for healing. Those on our hearts, especially John and Pat and Brower, and Wilma, and Bonnie, and Helen. Oh, Lord, and so many more that are on our hearts. So many. Father, we will not forget essential workers, those in the hospital, those that do everything in the hospital, no matter what it is, those that bring food that gets to our table, Father God, packages on our doorstep. Father God, just thank you for them. Put your hedge of protection around them, and may your holy angels bring them peace and comfort in this time that is scary at times. Thank you, Lord. The church, Father, we lift the church that you would give us wisdom, the larger church, but also this church, Cherryvale. And when it's time to open, and what we might do to protect those who need extra protection. But most of all, Father, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, who gave it all, said, yes, Father, I will answer you, who died and rose again on the third day. And now we pray the prayer Jesus taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen and amen. Praise God, praise God. We're in Romans 5, Romans 5, verses 1 through 11. Let's pray. Father God, push away the muck and the mire of this week. Push away it all. Open our senses that we might receive the message that you have for us, Father. And Father, I ask you to put me behind the cross, for no matter what I say, they will only hear the words you want them to hear. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. In Romans 5, we hear the title of peace and hope. For some, Bibles might say peace, hope, and glory, or peace and glory. Peace is a common word in the ancient world and can have many different meanings and characteristics. But for Paul, this peace is about the well-being, about prosperity, about salvation of godly people. Being justified. Let's read verse 1. Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Being justified by faith refers to the one act of faith, the moment when we trust Christ. We know that we have salvation, that it is permanent, that it is eternal, that God no longer has charges against us, that our sins have been forgiven. And everything is right between us and God, that everything is right between us and God. But we must remember, to keep working, to keep growing, always into the likeness of Jesus Christ. It is ongoing that we grow in grace and love, and we keep growing. And God calls us to do that. So let's hear verses 1, and then we'll extend it to verse 2 again. Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith into this grace in which we now stand. And we boast in hope of the glory of God. Access. We gain access to God through prayer. Through accepting Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. We pray and we talk and we communicate and we build relationship with God for ourselves, for our families, for our friends, for our country, for the world. We pray for many things. But we all should lift up thanks to God in the good times and in the not so good times. We have a God who is listening to us and who does answer our prayers. Now, that doesn't mean he answers our prayers the way we want him to answer them. But he always hears us. And sometimes he shows that he is a good, loving father by saying no. He will answer according to his wisdom, not according to our will. And yes, we may not always understand. And we also boast in hope. This hope in Scripture holds our future. Because we have hope in God and in God's grace for us. The children of God has a hope, a blessed hope. Let's look at Romans 8:28. Because we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purposes, not our purposes, but his. And Romans 8:39 tells us that neither height nor depth nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Powerful grace, a grace that only comes from the love of God. Let's look at verses 3 and 4. Not only so, but we also glory in our suffering, because we know that suffering produces perseverance. Perseverance, character, and character, hope. Whew, what a couple of verses. What is this saying? We have glory or joy in our suffering because suffering produces perseverance, and perseverance, character, and character, hope. Three words that go along with suffering: perseverance, character, and hope. At my lowest point in my life, in a depth of suffering beyond belief, that I thought this scripture was given to me as God, from God, and it was given to persevere, to grow in character, and to have a great hope that one day things would be better. We know that because it takes suffering to bring out the best. This is what I learned. It takes suffering to bring out the best in the believer's life. God used my suffering and my persevering to bring out a character that he wanted me to have and a hope that he wanted me to stand on. His grace. The only way, now listen, the only way God can produce good fruit in the life of a believer is by pruning our branches. And he does that through suffering, because suffering produces growth in the fruits of the Spirit. Growth. When we turn our lives over to him in our suffering, it produces character and it produces hope in his grace. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Verse 5. And hope does not put us to shame. Because God's love has been, listen, poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit, who has been given to us, poured into our hearts. I like that. Y'all like that? I do. Poured into our hearts. God's love for us is poured. And this love is made real through the power of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, who has been given to us. Okay, folks, here we go. Listen up. This is important. The only way we can truly feel the true love of God, the true love of God and how massive it is in our hearts, is through the power of the Holy Spirit. But we have to surrender. We have to give over to God freedom in our lives so that his power can just overtake us in ways we thought we could never experience. That love, so deep and so great, no matter what's going on in our lives, no matter what it is, it brings us great joy and hope and healing. Verse 6. You see, at just the right time, when we were still powerless, Christ died for the ungodly. Christ died for the ungodly, not for the good, you and I, but for the ungodly, the sinners, those who actually were his enemies, those who hated him. Christ died for you, for me, for them. Let's look at Luke 23, 34. Jesus said, at the point on the cross, he said, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. And they divided up his clothes by casting lots. Forgive them, for they know not what they are doing. Jesus on the cross, forgive them. And you and I were among the ungodly. But you know something, folks? We can't keep God from loving us. From loving us. God gave us hope, forgiveness, and healing, and grace through his son, Jesus Christ. Let's look at two other scriptures, Ephesians 2:8. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourself, it is the gift of God. And John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. God gave his Son to pay the penalty for my sin, for your sin. And we all must come to the Father through the Son. Through the Son. Those of us who are Christians, who call Jesus Christ our Savior, who call God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, the one and only God, we believe that this is the way to salvation, that this is the way through Christ to the Father. Let's look at verse 7. Very rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though for a good person, someone might possibly dare to die. Folks, do we know who would die for us? Could we feel the fingers on one hand with the names of people who would die for our sins? Do we realize, do we understand that God has sent his Son to die for our sins? Would anyone else die for our sins, for my sins? But God's grace in his Son and through his Son, Jesus Christ. Wow. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Son. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you. Verse 8. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Christ died for you. Christ died for me. This is where God shows his love for us. And God is holding out. Listen here, y'all. Yo, listen. God is holding out his arms, ready, ready to save his children today. Do you know Jesus as your Savior today? Do you know him as your Savior today? Say a prayer. Let's say the sinner's prayer. Let's say, as I repeat after me, dear God, I want you to be a part of my life. Yes. And I want to be part of your family. You said in your word that if I acknowledge that you raised Jesus from the dead, and that I accept him as my Lord and Savior, I would be saved. So God, I now say I believe you raised Jesus from the dead, and that he is alive and well. I accept him now as my personal Lord and Savior. I accept my salvation from sin right now. I am now saved. Jesus is my Lord. Jesus is my Savior. Thank you. Thank you, Father God, for forgiving me, saving me, and giving me eternal life with you. Amen and amen. Bless y'all. Father, fill them with your Holy Spirit, those who have said this prayer. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Let's look at verse 9. Since we have now been justified by his blood, how much more shall we be saved from God's wrath through him? We have been saved from the penalty of sin. Christ is constantly saving us day to day from the power of sin. Satan is always working on us, always pulling us and tugging at us. And Jesus is at the Father saying, come on, Father. Come on, Holy Spirit. Bring Vivian closer to you. We are saved from God's wrath by God's grace through the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, sister, hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. We thank you. Yes. Let's look at verse 10 and 11. For if while we were God's enemies, we were reconciled to him through the death of his son, how much more, having been reconciled, shall we be saved through his life? Not only is this so, but we also boast in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through him whom we have now received reconciliation. Thank you, Jesus. He has reconciled us through the Father. To the Father, he has reconciled us. Jesus died here on earth to save us. Jesus lives with the Father to keep us saved. To keep us saved through the power of the Holy Spirit. Will we surrender to his will? Will we receive the grace? Will we receive the joy? Will we be comforted in this great word of God? Grace. Grace. Will we grow in our suffering? Will we grow in hope? Right now. Right now, wherever, whatever is going on in your life, we can have joy. We can rejoice. Why? Glad you asked. Because we have received reconciliation with God through Jesus Christ, his Son. If nothing else today, in your suffering, persevere, and you will go in character and hope in our Savior, Jesus Christ. Yes, God is working on you. He's working. He's working on me. And this grace should bring great joy to your heart. Show this grace to all you come in contact with today and going forward. Amen and amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And now we come to bless the gifts and tithes and offerings that you have sent in. Some people have asked about our new system and if there's any more need. So there is a little more need if you would like to help with that. We don't have to draw out of the general fund that pays regular stuff. So if you like to, we have about 1,500 or so to 2,000 that we would not have to draw out of the regular fund. So if you like to donate to that opposite of your general fund, this is above the general fund, if you are able. I know that some people are not able at this time, but some people have asked, so I told them that I would let people know. So let us pray for all that has come in and all the blessings that has come to us. Father God, we just thank you and praise you and glorify you. We ask the blessing on the gifts, the tithes and the offerings that have come in this week. We ask that you would multiply them a thousandfold to make disciples for Jesus Christ and to ease the pain and suffering in your world. Father God, bless those who have given it. Bless them, Lord, that they may have abundance for their blessing, that they have a growing and supporting your kingdom in a much different way than they ever have. But we thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' holy name, amen and amen. Well, whoo, the Holy Spirit was powerful today. Amen, Sister Luana? All right. Yes, indeed. Amen. It was powerful. Came upon. So I'm praying for y'all. If you need something, call the office on Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, 9 to 2. Text me, email, whatever you need to. And if you need to talk, may God bless you and keep you. Amen.